What's up guys, Tech Techno Video. In the video today we're going to take a look at the IMI tube amplifier. So this amplifier has two tubes inside and it can put a power of 100 watts officially, but you can get a peak power of 200 watts on both ports. So it is a left and right channel amplifier. So it's definitely meant for two speakers, so passive speakers. So let's take a look inside. So here are the specifications. So it uses Bluetooth ATX HD, also Bluetooth 5.1. So not the latest one, but pretty recent one. So here you see it, 200 watts plus 200. And there are some things you have to consider when using this kind of amplifier. There's also an antenna. Then we'll take out the amplifier. So I do have to say, it looks very cool. It's made out of metal, so metal build quality. And on the rear, you have the ports. You also have an audio in port in case you want to have wired audio. So here we have the power brick, or the power adapter. I do have to say it's pretty big. Also has some power in it. And then we go to the tubes. So I do have to say the tubes are here. With tubes you always have to be careful with removing them because they can break. But they do look very cool. So I'll now pair it up with my, not this speakers, but yeah, with my Teufel speakers. And we'll see how they perform. So the treble and the bass now on the middle level. I will turn the bass a little bit up and the treble also. So first impressions, a really great amplifier for this kind of speakers, especially the bass and the treble. If you adjust them, it's not like an EQ that the sound gets very strange or very like disformed or something like that. And the tubes, maybe you can see it a little bit on the camera, maybe not. I will zoom a little bit in. You can see them burn a little bit, and that's normal with tubes. It's kind of funny to see this happen in real life. So I will play a different song now to see how that one performs. And then we're going to see how this amplifier is. We'll be right back. also do the bass a lot stronger, but the speakers do have a little bit of limitation. For example, they don't really go much lower than 80 Hz. But with this amplifier, I do have to say, you do have a little bit more in the lower side. One thing I do notice with this amplifier is if you put the volume off, you do hear a little bit of sound. Maybe it has to do with the tubes, or maybe just that the amplifier has some background sound. So today I have connected with this new Philips speakers. They are not new, but I bought it new for the amplifier. Because in the previous test I used the Teufel speakers, that are my rear surround speakers, and they work very great and fine with this amplifier. But I wanted to see how it will perform with smaller speakers. And as you could see in the previous song that I tried on the speaker, it really sounds very cool. And the funny thing is, when I was unpacking this amplifier, I've noticed a few things. The overall build quality is very great. It's very, very strong build quality, except the tubes. So, yeah, they can't really change that. The tubes, you have to be careful with. They can break, but the funny thing is you can use around 5 or 6 different tubes on this amplifier. So, in case this one breaks, you can buy different ones or the same one again. And they aren't very expensive, this model. For example, you can maybe buy them for $20-$25, those tubes, and that's fine. I do notice with the Teufel, you do get a little bit more, I would say, clearer sound. These Philips speakers are great, especially the bass response is very great for the size and also for the overall power output. Overall, I think it's a very great amplifier, especially for the price. If you can get it under 100 euros or $100, sometimes it's on sale. Yeah, it's definitely a very great offer and buy to get. So we'll play another song to see how that one is performing. So let's see. Let's do this one. So this first activation. So let's wait. And there it is, the song.